I'm Alex with Splunk Education. Let's take a look at how to run basic searches in Splunk's Search and Reporting app. On the sidebar of the Splunk homepage, we select Search and Reporting. The app includes a search bar for entering our searches, a time range picker for the search, a menu to view and rerun past searches, links to the search documentation and tutorial, information on the data Splunk has indexed, and an option to create table views, which allow you to explore your data in a point-and-click interface. In this demo, we'll be using Splunk's search processing language to explore Apache server data from a fictional gaming company, Buttercup Games. We want to see if 503 errors are occurring on our web servers, so we type 503 in the search bar. As we type, the Splunk Search Assistant displays contextual matches, keyword completion, and syntax documentation for the search. We only want to see when an error happened over the last 7 days, so we select last 7 days in the time range picker. Limiting search by time is key to getting more efficient results and is a best practice to use for every search. Once the time range is selected, we click the search icon to send the search to Splunk. The interface updates to show events that include the text 503, a sidebar of fields that were extracted from the events, and a timeline of when the events happened. Since we searched for any event with the text 503, events could include an HTTP status code, an area code, a username, even the name of a file in our data. To limit our results to only see return events containing an HTTP status of 503, we can search for a field value pair. In the field sidebar, we see a field called status. Clicking on the field name, we have links to quick reports, values returned, and statistics for those values. We change our search to use a field value pair by adding the case-sensitive field name to the value we want to find. Now, only events with a status of 503 are returned. To see all errors in the 500 range, we can use a wildcard. Changing the last character to an asterisk will return any HTTP error that begins in 50. We can add additional terms to our search by using the uppercase booleans and, or, and not. To return results containing events with a status in the 500 range, or a 404 status, we add or status is equal to 404 in our search. The Splunk search bar includes syntax highlighting. Here, you can see the Boolean operator is colored orange, making it easier to see what has been happening in our search. If no Boolean is used between search terms, AND is implied. The search returns no events because Splunk is looking for events with a status in the 500s and a 404 status. We can also use the comparison operators of equal, not equal, less than or equal to, greater than, or greater than or equal to in our search. To see any events with a status greater than 400, we add a greater than operator. To exclude any events containing a status of 400 from our events, we use the not equal to operator. To search for phrases, we can wrap the search terms in quotes. To see all events related to our video game, Dream Crusher, we search the product name field for the phrase Dream Crusher. If we remove the quotes, no events will be returned. This is because Splunk is searching for events that contain both the product name value of Dream and the text Crusher. We can also modify our search by interacting with events. As we roll over text in an event, terms are highlighted. Clicking on a search term allows us to add it to the search, remove it from the search, or create a new search. Clicking Add to Search updates our search to return only events that contain the selected term. We can also add terms from the field sidebar by clicking the field name and selecting the value we want to add to the search. We can open a whole new world of monitoring and analyzing by adding commands to our searches. This search returns all successful purchases from our web store over the last 7 days. Appending a stats command with the sum function and splitting our results by product name, Splunk returns a table of our total sales by game title. This transforming search also allows us to visualize the data in a column chart. Or we can use a time chart command to see how our products have been selling by day. Clicking on Column Chart opens the visualization menu, where we can select a different visualization style. The format menu provides additional visual formatting options, while the trellis layout allows us to split our visualization by a selected field, creating multiple visualizations while running only one search. We have just scratched the surface of Splunk's search processing language. We suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.